So for lesson number two, we're going to discuss multiple linear regression and some nonlinear regression. Multiple regression is an interpolating method which can be used to predict the value of a dependent variable based on known values of two or more variables. In most cases, the regression analysis applied always involves more than one independent variables in the regression model. Now, if the regression model is linear in the coefficients, it is called multiple linear regression. In this part, we will just consider multiple linear regression. Now, using R-squared, the coefficient of determination, we can verify if the regression model is a good fit. Using some statistical tests such as ANOVA and t-test, we can determine if the relationship among the variables from your sample also exists in large population. So we will focus only on finding the regression model in this lesson. So for three independent variables, let's say x sub 1, x sub 2, and x sub 3, the estimated dependent variable may be obtained by the regression model, which is y is equal to the constant b sub o plus the coefficient b sub 1 multiplied by x sub 1 plus coefficient b sub 2 multiplied by x sub 2 plus b sub 3 multiplied by x sub 3. So using the least squares method. For nonlinear independent variable, x, the estimated dependent variable may be obtained in a similar manner by this polynomial regression model. So k here is the degree of the polynomial. So this is another interpolating method which can be used if there exists nonlinear relationship between two variables. So the R or the value of the correlation coefficient is close to zero. We can minimize the residual errors in our regression model by differentiation. So multiple linear regression model for the response y sub I is given as follows. So you have here your response y sub I, that which is equal to the fitted value y sub I plus the residual error. And your fitted value y sub I is equal to the estimated combination of the coefficients and then your values for x sub 1, x sub 2, x sub 3 in the ith column, or rather ith row. The error sum of squares is given by this formula. Or that is ESS, that is the sum of the square of the difference between the response and your fitted value. Okay, so I will take the values from 1 to n. So n is the number of samples. So using the least squares method, we differentiate the error sum of squares. So differentiating this with respect to the unknown coefficients, b sub o, b sub 1, b sub 2, b sub 3. Okay, and then equate the resulting equations to 0. The resulting equations, or this process, will result to 4 normal linear equations. And the normal equations can be reduced into matrix equation. Okay, so you have this, okay, as your coefficient matrix, and then under the unknown coefficients, b sub o, b sub 1, b sub 2, b sub 3, And then this is the column of constants. So for example, the first equation contains n b sub o plus b sub sum x1 times b sub 1, sum of x2 times b sub 2, sum of x3 times b sub 3 is equal to sum of y. So for example, here you have sum of square f sub 1, x sub 1, so you square the value of x sub 1 for each row and then get the sum, okay, along that column under x sub 1 squared and so on and so forth. The coefficient matrix A is symmetric and non-singular, which means the determinant is non-zero. So we'll be using the inverse matrix solution, so A must be non-singular. So we can compute for the inverse matrix. We can use the coefficient of determination R squared to show the accuracy of your fitted regression model. So this quantity indicates the proportion of variation described by the independent variables. So R squared is given by this formula, RSS, your residual sum of squares. This is the total sum of the squares. Okay, so these are the formulas for the regression for RSS and then TSS. So this is for the response Y sub I. So y bar here is the average of the y values, and note that from your residual or errors sum of squares, no, the total sum of squares is equal to regression sum of squares plus the error sum of squares. So this is what we obtained or we discussed from the previous slide, the one we differentiated. Okay, the survival rate of sperm in percentage form represented by the variable y from an animal semen was measured at different concentrations represented by x sub 1, x sub 2, and x sub 3. Using three types of materials, the data obtained are given in the following table. So we find the multiple regression model for the given data, and then we use R squared to test if the regression model we obtain is a good fit. And then we estimate the percent survival rate if x sub 1, x sub 2, and x sub 3 are given. Okay, so this is the table. So we have four columns here. The first column is for the percent survival, and then x sub 1, x sub 2, x sub 3, the percentage weight, no, from second column to third column. And then we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 samples. Okay, I'll be using the Excel for our solution using the least squares method. Okay, so I'll start with okay, the multiple regression. Okay, so I have created columns for the x1 squared, x sub 2 squared, and so on up to the product of y and x sub 3. Okay, so I base it from the normal equation. So this is the normal equation. Okay, for the given data. Okay, so you have, okay, so we will be needing the sum of x sub 1 squared, x sub 2 squared, x sub 3 squared, and then the product, okay, of the three combinations of the three variables, and then y with each of the independent variables. Okay, so I'll start here. So square x1, and then click the cursor downward to copy the formula. Okay, also with x squared. Okay, and then select x3, and then you square, then do it with the other entries, and then the product of x1 and x2, the product of x1 and x3, and then the product of x2 and x3, and then copy. Okay, and then this time y with x1, y with x2, and then y with x3. Okay, move the cursor downward. Again, the next step is to get the sum of each column, but we need to get the y bar here. This is the average, okay, of the y values. Okay, and then the sum. Okay, so sum. So select the column, and then I can move the cursor to the right to copy the formula. Okay, so we can check. Okay, so we're selecting the correct cell. So okay, and then okay, we start with n. The first entry is 13. Oh, sorry, this is 10. So select, and then sum of x1, sum of x1, this one, sum of x2, sum of x3. Now this is symmetric, so we just copy the entries here. This is non-singular symmetric, and then we have the, okay, the diagonal entries for the square of x1, square of x, x1, x2, square of x3, and then v2, we have product of x1, x2, so this one, and then x2, x2, x3, or x1, x3 rather, and then this is symmetric. Okay, so we copy the entries here, then the last one, sum of x2 and x3. So this is your x2, x3, x2, x3, And then we have sum of y. This is sum of y. Okay. Yx1, yx2, yx3. Select. Okay. So we check if the coefficient matrix is non-singular. So we use MD term to get the determinant of the coefficient matrix. Okay. And then enclosed. Oh, sorry. This is MD term. Okay, then enter. Huh? Okay, wait. So this is M, the term, M, the term, and then select. Okay, so this is non-zero, therefore the matrix inverse exists, or the coefficient matrix is non-singular. So we can proceed to finding the matrix inverse. So select the 4x4 cells. Okay, and then on the first cell, input the function that is M inverse. And then select the array. Your coefficient matrix and close, and then okay, use control shift, then press enter. So control shift, then enter to generate the entries of your inverse. Okay, and then we use multiplication of matrices to get your solution. So this is the cells for your solution. Okay, so select, and then on the first cell you type mmult, the operation for multiplication. So you have two arrays here, so start with inverse. So select your inverse, okay, and then comma, and then the column of constant. So multiplying the inverse matrix by the column of constants, now we get the solution. Okay, and then again control shift enter to generate the entry. So we have here the coefficient. So if you want to write down your equation, so we have here 32.7582 plus 1.0357 x1 plus, or rather minus 1.5177 x2 plus 0.04607. So for as much as possible, avoid rounding off the numbers, no, especially for very small coefficients. Okay, so this is x3, and then we're asked to find the value of y given the x1, x2, and x3. Okay, so for example, so this is just an example. So let's say you have here 11. Okay, and then we just select the coefficients. Okay, the constant, the coefficient times the value of x1 plus the coefficient times the value of x2, coefficient times the value of x3. Okay, so this is the estimated value of y when x1 is 28 x2 is 13, and then x3 is 11.